Yeah, what's up, guys? My name is Moshe Ndiki. Moshe Ndiki, I'm the writer, and I'm going to be the Yulen, and welcome to the Behind the Scenes shoot with our October cover star. She sings, she writes, and I'm sure all best in the geezers of us know people say, do you also fix the geezers?
No, I don't fix geezers, but I can fix my washing machine.
Okay, so she also fixes washing machines, and she also sings, she acts, directs, and things which are away by each other.
No, but Tengisi M-Way.
Oh, okay. Tengisi M-Way, and blankets, is there anything? She also sells
the blankets. Yeah, those double ones, those nice.
Not the prison ones. Oh, the ones
that. The Rolls Royces of the blankets.
The Rolls
Royces. Every black family deserves that blanket.
Oh, is there not the ones?
Yes.
Oh,
yeah, yeah.
Okay. So, no more winter, basically.
No winter.
Sister Rami, thank you so much for joining us. How are you doing?
Fine, how are you?
Oh, I'm good. You're so beautiful. You remind me of me.
I know, Chef. I know. Especially ears, they kind of look the same.
Yes, yeah, they do. We've got really, really cute ears.
Mm-hmm.
Someone said my ears are some satellite dish, and I was like, you know what? I've got compact, so.
Yeah,
I'm
not so compact.
I don't think so, but for the sake of the interview, we'll say, okay, we can go with that.
I can't work like this. That's what I'm telling you right now.
So, Lisa, please tell me about your journey, how you got into acting, performing, to performance, and if not acting, what would you be doing?
Well, I figured that school was hard, so I thought, let me find something fun to do. Okay, I'm kidding, it's a lie.
This coming from a veteran actress, guys. You can just imagine.
I don't know, what was that, guys? Like I started acting such a long time ago.
Mm-hmm.
When must I start?
Wait, like, so you've always known that acting is your thing?
Yeah.
When?
No. I think the first time I figured that I'll get into the entertainment industry was in 1984, when I danced at my aunt's wedding, and people threw money at me because I was so fabulous.
Shit.
That's why I didn't do free gigs, guys.
Yeah!
I got paid.
Not even for an NGO. Not even for an NGO.
I'm on go, I pick the ones I want.
Yeah, I've got a birthday coming up, it's for a good cause. No.
Next question.
Okay, if not acting and performance, what would you be doing?
I would have been a Formula One driver.
Is it?
Yeah. I love driving, I love fast cars, I love racing. Well, not on the roads, guys.
Yeah, you might just want to.
I'm a very good. Yeah, no, I don't do it like that, but I mean, I would love to be a Formula One driver.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so right now, do you drive a very fast car?
It's okay, it's not a fast car. It's just a car, it goes,
it gives the people going.
Yeah.
Alright, so now tell me about your new character, Gracious Mabuza, and what are the similarities and differences between you guys?
I don't look like Gracious, I don't dress like Gracious,
okay.
And I definitely don't have Gracious's hair. No.
Yeah, Gracious's hair.
And I don't wear velvet like Gracious.
What's
and
wrong?
Gracious is over the top.
What's wrong with Gracious as well, but?
Yeah. Guys, no. It's that one.
The Fanduka.
Yeah, the one from Belombre.
Yeah, it's not even velvet, it's velvet.
Yeah, it's velvet.
Yeah, it's velvet.
Yeah.
So it's not a good
look.
Yeah.
Okay. She loves wearing gold pants and she loves big rings and lots of animal print and
And
makeup and big hair.
And similarities, because I saw the way that you handled that gun. I was like, I don't know if I can tell the difference now. If it's you, is it hair? Is it you? Is it hair? Because the way you just handled that gun.
It's hair with that gun. I know how to handle a gun, but I've never shooted anybody. So that was Gracious, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
No, you've never shoot even that?
No, never. I'm a peace loving person.
Thank you so much. Peace or love, no bullets, no douche, no douche, and no velvet, and none of
that. But what I like about Gracious is that she is, she's so out there, she's such an extrovert. She thinks there's going to be world peace. I don't know how, but she believes in nice things. She loves beautiful things and loves nice things. As long as you don't cross her and you're loyal to her, then you guys are good.
Alright, so what do you think or would you say has been your most challenging role ever? Because of all the roles that I've seen, you slay each and every one of them. So it looks like you wake up and you're like, oh, okay, cool, let me just become this person and clench. Yes, I'm clenching, so I forgot being low too. Yes, I'm clenching, so I forgot being low too. How do you channel those different characters?
I think each and every character that I've acted in, I've known people who are like that. So I just thought, okay, I'm going to channel Mrs. Mazibuko, and boom, we've got a character.
Okay. Yeah. You don't know Mrs. Mazibuko might be watching this.
No, she's definitely in church. Gracious, I pick a couple of characters and then I gel them together.
All right.
And then add a bit of spice, obviously.
Okay.
But I think, in fact, all characters that we see on TV, even when the writers write,
okay,
they've got someone in mind. So there is a gracious mother out there, there's a commotion out there, there are all those different characters, they're all there.
All right.
Yeah, and gracious is a collection of a few people.
Because
and most of them I found them in church, they're church people.
Exactly, because sometimes you see her cutting cocaine, you see her praying, quoting verses, and you're like the apostle who's, and you're like, but wait, you were just cutting cocaine, just.
Yeah. Yeah, it's the hustle.
It has to be a thespian. I don't use words just like, oh, to be an actor, it's just a
thespian,
darling, thespian. So tell me, your book is there, because for me, the way I'm looking at you right now, it's like, you're so full of life, there's still so much more that you still need to do. There's still so much more that you're going to do. Is there going to be another book from the first one?
Yeah, well, my first book is over and done with, and it is fun, it's all about me, it's short stories, it's my book.
Yeah.
And then the second book is something different altogether.
Okay.
It's 5 different storylines, and they are killing me, because I get so much writer's blocks, like a lot of writer's blocks in my life right now. But yeah, it's a cool book, I'm looking forward to it, it's going to be nice.
So there is a second book?
Yeah, I've started writing it last year already.
Okay.
Yeah.
Any dates, maybe?
No, not yet.
Oh, coming to school.
But this thing is coming out of my pocket. When I hire me and pay me, then I can be able to release the book.
Okay, how about we make it to
10%,
and then I help you out with some of.
You find the money.
Yeah.
Ah, then that's perfect.
Oh,
all right,
sure.
Absolutely, I agree.
So besides writing and acting and stage directing, what else are you doing?
I don't know what else I'm doing. I cook, I dance at home with my kids.
So guys, she cooks. Can you just, in front of the camera, are you going to invite us over?
How? What are you saying? People have been coming to eat at my house. When are we? Okay, fine, I'll invite you the next time.
Thank you so much. You know, imagine just going to someone's house, go, and then I catch up, and then you're like, we didn't invite you. I need to broccoli, and next thing in Bagera, you mean in that, because I was not invited.
No, we'll give you 10 wings.
Okay, thank you so much. We'll see Mama each other. Thank you so much for joining us. Behind the scenes, did you enjoy the cover shoot?
I did. It's been stunning. It's been amazing. I look like a superstar.
Babe, you look like a superstar every day, all day, every day, you know?
I was slaying. I didn't get a couple
of laughs.
Must be the last one. No, must be the last one.